Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics Live. Woo! Coming up, we'll take a closer look at SQL Server 2019, now generally available. We'll look at its expanded role as a data integration platform, allowing you to bring in data from any source, including on the edge, for analysis. In fact, we'll show you how data location becomes irrelevant with a scenario that goes from ground to the cloud and introduce you to Azure SQL Database Edge. So I'm pleased to be joined today by Buck Woody, an applied data scientist from the SQL engineering team. Welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me on the show.
It's good to have you. Now, congratulations on the milestone. Mm-hmm. We've come full circle since last time around
when
Travis Wright was on the show, giving us an overview. So tell us now, we're generally available.
That's right. It's a huge milestone. And one of the big improvements we've delivered on is including increasing the shift from SQL Server being a relational database engine only to a full data integration platform where you can access your data without always having to import it. And what this does for us, it removes database silos, and it makes it easier to manage and query data at scale. And it kind of makes SQL Server a data hub. We've also got a new architecture designed to give you huge improvements in performance through caching and parallel processing, as well as elastic scale compute and storage. Now, this architecture deeply integrates SQL Server's parallel query engine with big data components like Spark and HDFS. And these are all included in the box with SQL Server. And it gives you a single architecture, right? So it's easy to deploy and to manage, and it's fully supported by Microsoft. Now, even though the engine has several deployment targets, it's the same engine across all of them. You can deploy to containers using container orchestration systems like Kubernetes and OpenShift. And of course, we still support bare metal installations for like Linux and Windows. And now, as you pointed out, even ARM-based devices. So this gives us possibilities for high availability and scale. And so it's really all about choice from the ground and the edge to the cloud.
Awesome. Now, I know a lot of people are coming from older versions. So we'll get the sense from the audience here. So a little bit of an ad hoc survey.
Yeah.
How many people are running SQL Server 2017
2017,
today?
Raise your hands. Oh, nice.
OK, good.
Nice.
Excellent. Yeah, congratulations. Yeah, yeah. What about 2016?
OK, get a little older.
A few more
OK,
hands.
That's
yeah,
fine.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah. OK, OK. 2012?
Uh-oh, getting a little older.
Okay. All right, okay.
No, no, don't.
No. 2008?
Oh, please. Oh, no.
Older than that?
Older than that.
Oh, wow, okay.
Let's
make this real for people then. So some of the changes, what changed for people, and why should people upgrade?
Yeah, so as a data professional, for me, the first thing I think about is the security and safety of my platform. That's the first thing I focus on. And we call this mission-critical security. Now, in addition to general surface updates on the security, we've made some specific improvements that will help you secure your data and application. So let me show you
a couple of these.
So basically here you can see we can now add classifications to our data. And you can do that right inside Transact-SQL. And we've even got a wizard here, right? So this thing went through and found some things that I might want to think about for classifications. And it's found three that it says, look, I found you've got payment methods and you've got email addresses and so on. So I could click here and I can accept these or I can add my own classifications and come up with whatever I want. I get a information type and a sensitivity level.
Right.
And then all we have to do once we're done with that is just run a report. And here's my classification report. This is ready for the audit. Now, something that's very important to note here is that I can view all this alongside because this is stored right in line with the metadata inside SQL Server now. Mm-hmm. So I can run my SQL Server audit functions and get the same kind of things and get those automated auditing type things done.
Excellent. Yeah. Nice. So are there any other new security improvements we should make people aware of?
There really are. There's a new hardware protocol, a chip, actually, that's been included with a lot of systems, even some virtualized hardware. And it's called a secure enclaves. It's for data encryption and decryption on a chip.
Right.
And SQL Server 2019 is designed to use these new chips when they're on the system.
Cool. So we know security is always incredibly important.
Right.
But for SQL Server, so is performance. So what are we doing to make SQL Server 2019 even faster?
Yeah, so we're always looking for ways to improve SQL Server performance. But most of the time, you've got to alter your code to get the new advantages inside that feature for performance increase. So what we wanted to do was be able to increase performance, but you don't have to change your code. By simply upgrading to the new version, you get an immediate performance boost. Nice. Now, we call this set of improvements intelligent query processing. Can I show you one quick example?
I'd love to see.
Okay,
yeah.
Let me show you this. Let me just pop over here to Management Studio. So what I've done here is I've created a stored procedure with a table variable, and that's great, and it's good. But the processor under like SQL Server 2016, I've got that set here, can't quite figure out the right plan to get. So when I run this, I get a different kind of plan. But I can simply change the compatibility level. And see, I've got exactly the same code here, exactly the same code. And when I run this, let me show you what it does. When I run it under the old model, 2016, you can see here that the plan's kind of high, and it can't quite figure out, it can't guess the number of rows because it's a table variable that it's trying to do. But simply by changing the compatibility mode, you can see now that it gets much, much faster because it can figure out the rows. And it also does some other things inside the query plan. So the output is basically this. The query processing engine is more accurate about the number of rows and the things it needs to do, and the query just speeds up.
Awesome. Now, we've seen quite a few updates this week for developers and for hybrid with Azure Data Studio, really at the center of all of that, both for developers and admins. Mm-hmm. What's new in ADS for SQL Server 2019?
Okay, so that's great, and we'll get to that in a moment. But before we get to the new tools, we have made improvements inside SQL Server Management Studio to take advantage of these things inside SQL Server 2019, so that tool's still around. But as you said, there's a new, completely new cross-platform developer environment that works on SQL Server in all its deployment models, and Windows, and Linux, and Apple, and so on. It's called Azure Data Studio. Here, let me kind of show you this. So you can see here, it's just a tool I can run inside and hit my clusters and so on. And if you'll look here, we've actually also included Jupyter Notebooks, if you're familiar with those. And you can run text and queries and so on. But something you may not recognize here, we've actually got a SQL kernel running in a Jupyter notebook. In fact, we've got a PowerShell kernel as well, but we've got a SQL kernel running in a Jupyter notebook, and that's a first that we've done there. And we've also got the tools running on multiple platforms, but we also have the engine running on multiple new platforms. For instance, we now have a SQL Server running on Azure SQL Edge, which means you can run the engine on ARM, like small IoT devices. Now, so perhaps there's a scenario, right, where you don't have a classic server rack, but you need to run a connected SQL database. So let's think about this. Imagine if we're running a shipping company, right? Okay. And we've got refrigerated trucks in our fleet, and we know that batteries can fail, and that causes refrigeration to fail, right?
Yeah, okay, so how do we solve for that with SQL?
Yeah, so normally what we need to do is something called preventative maintenance. We replace the batteries every 6 months or whatever. But what we really want to do is predictive maintenance, where we replace the battery when we need to based on actual data. So if you'll look inside my Azure Data Studio here, you'll see I've actually got a Jupyter notebook that includes everything I need to do this. I bring in some data. I've started a Spark application. I'm using the Azure Big Data Clusters inside here. And I'm reading in from the truck the data that it's streamed up. So I know all the features and the labels that I need. And now I can train those, and I can do a little feature engineering all right inside this notebook. And then what I can do is I can create a model to do the predictions. I can then test the model. And then once I'm all done, I can actually package this up, this model, in a container to deploy out to the trucks.
Okay, so how do we get it running on the truck?
Okay, you want to run it on the truck.
Yes.
Okay, so what we do is we push the container with the model down to the truck, and it's got an IoT ARM device running SQL Edge, and it actually does the predictions. Now, here's what can happen. The truck can inform the driver in real time before the battery is predicted to fail. It can map the location of the truck and the service center to make sure the parts are shipped. The service team can be scheduled to replace it at that location.
Okay, so what does a prediction actually look like?
Well, here, I'll show you. Let's go back to the notebook here. We scroll down, and you can see some Transact-SQL. Now, notice it can run wherever Transact-SQL can run.
Excellent.
And I'm simply going to query right out of the truck. I'm going to get the data I need to do the prediction. And then here we are. I get the truck sensor reading right back in the truck. So that triggers the workflow to map the location of the truck. And the service center, find the part, schedule the work, notify the driver. Isn't that cool?
That's awesome. And that is essentially a full end-to-end brown to cloud scenario, and you didn't have to actually move the data.
No, you square right where it is.
And the edge scenario we talked about, also another great addition. Now, I know a lot of people watching are probably thinking, well, will my existing apps continue to work?
And yeah.
So what, if anything, changes for them?
Yeah, we're always careful about compatibility in SQL Server. We know you've got a lot of code out there. Most of the time, your application doesn't require a lot of code changes. When we do deprecate a feature, it stays in the next few versions to give you time to alter your code. Most everything we do here is additive, right? So not something we take away. So you don't need to necessarily change what you're doing. Now, going forward, our idea is to certify on the compatibility level, not the version,
right.
Something you can set. Like you see, I did that right here. I set the compatibility level here. And then you can upgrade the server version with the knowledge that your application's just kind of going to work.
Right, and that's at the database level.
That's right. Now, another advantage, and I'll show you that here, is that the Transact-SQL statements you write for one platform are going to work on another. And basically, I showed you this kind of earlier. The general idea is that the code written for Azure SQL Database Edge will work on SQL Server 2019 for Windows, Linux, and containers, and Kubernetes, and Azure SQL, because it's the same engine, right? So you've got peace of mind that we're doing everything we can to make SQL Server the most durable, capable platform for your data, regardless of sort of the shape or the size.
Okay, so just to reiterate and make it clear, the code that I write is completely transferable across the different platforms.
Yeah, in large part, that's true, yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for joining us today, but we've learned a lot. I'm sure everyone is appreciative of that as well.
Yeah.
Where can people learn a little bit more?
We've got a ton of good documentation at microsoft.com/SQL, and we've got full workshops and example code and all kinds of goodness over at aka.ms/SQL workshops.
Excellent. Great to see all the updates this week for SQL Server and all the things we're doing with data. Now, remember to keep watching Microsoft Mechanics. Hit subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.